Everyone, I am Malleshwari, work for the Department of Chemistry in BRR and GKR Chambers Degree College. Welcome to the chapter Dilute Solutions. In the past videos, we have been discussing colligative properties. Colligative properties are the properties of solution which depends on the amount of solute and do not depends on what the solute is. They do not depends on the nature of the solute. I told you that there are four colligative properties. One is relative lowering of vapor pressure. Second one is elevation in boiling point. Third one is depression in freezing point. And fourth one is osmotic pressure. We discussed the first two colligative properties, relative lowering of vapor pressure and elevation in boiling point. We now come to the third colligative property, that is the depression in freezing point. But before I discuss the depression and the freezing point, let us briefly revise what we did in previous colligative properties, where we talked of the elevation in boiling point. Why there is an elevation in boiling point is what you understand when you do the first colligative property, where we see that there is a relative lowering of vapor pressure. So, as a result of relative lowering of vapor pressure, the boiling point of the solution is always higher than that of the pure solvent. And why is that in the solvent? This is the curve. If the temperature of the vapor pressure, but if it is the curve of the pure solvent, when you added solute to it, to the molecules of the solute occupied the surface and some of the surface area, and therefore the surface area available for evaporation decreases. The result which the boiling point of the vapor pressure, it decreases, and since the vapor pressure decreases, the boiling point increases, and that's why the boiling point of the solution is greater. What is the boiling point? Boiling point is the temperature at which vapor pressure of any substance becomes equal to the 1 atmospheric pressure. Now, at this temperature, if this is vapor pressure of the pure solvent becomes equal to the vapor pressure of the atmospheric pressure. But when you add it to the solute, the vapor pressure of the solution was lesser, and therefore the vapor pressure of it took longer, or you had to heat it up even more so that the vapor pressure of the solution would become equal to the vapor pressure to the atmospheric pressure. When that happened at a higher temperature, you obtained the boiling point. So the boiling point of the solution is greater or larger, higher than the boiling point of the solvent. We know that the boiling point of the solvent, we understand, is never going to move on with this. If the boiling point, what is melting point of the freezing point? Freezing point or melting point is basically the same temperature, only the process is different. Melting is when the solid gets converted into a liquid, and freezing is when liquid gets converted into solids. So either way, it's just basically the same temperature, so it's a freezing. Since we talk in terms of freezing point, we'll say freezing point is the temperature at which the vapor pressure of the solid and the liquid becomes equal. When the vapor pressure of the solid and liquid become equal at the temperature, we call, if it is the freezing point or the melting point, just as we said in the case of boiling point, then the temperature at which the vapor pressure of the liquid becomes equal to the atmospheric pressure. In the same way, you will be discussing the freezing point, we say it is the temperature at which the vapor pressure of the liquid state becomes equal to the vapor pressure of the solid state. Look at this graph. Now we are showing freezing this is the solvent point of the curve, and second one is the solution curve, and third one is the solution two. In this graph, on x axis temperature and y axis vapor pressure. So definition of the freezing point is the temperature at which the liquid and the solid states of a substance are in equilibrium with each other, are defined as temperature at which liquid and the solid states of a substance have the same vapor pressure. From previous knowledge, we know that vapor pressure of a liquid is lowered by the addition of a non-volatile solute. Hence, it is impelled that the freezing point of the solvent will be lowered by the addition of a non-volatile solute. Hence, it is impelled that the freezing point of a solvent will be lowered by the addition of a non-volatile solute. In other words, freezing point of a solution will be lower than the freezing point of the pure solvent. If T0 is the freezing point of the pure solvent and T is the freezing point of the solution, the differences in the two freezing points is called depression in freezing point. So students, the definition of the freezing point, depression in freezing point, is the differences between the freezing point of the pure solvent and freezing point of the solution is called depression in freezing point, which it is denoted by delta T or delta TF. Thus, in short, depression in freezing point delta TF equal to T naught minus T. In this graph, on x-axis temperature and y-axis vapor pressure, and temperature is denoted by T1, T0, T2, and vapor pressure is P0, P1, P2, and the solvents solution 1 and solution 2 on the curves AB and DE and GH. The depression in freezing point of the solvent due to the addition of a non-volatile solute can readily understand from the vapor pressure curves of the pure solvents and two different solutions, that is solution 1 and solution 2. That is solution 1 and solution 2 in the same solvents. Curve AB represents the vapor pressure of the solvent at different temperatures. At this point B, the liquid solvent starts the solids, and hence at this point liquid solvent are in equilibrium with each other. In other words, at a point B is the solid, at the liquid solvent have the same vapor pressure. The temperature corresponds to the point B will be thus in freezing point of the pure solvent T naught. When whole of the liquid solvent has been solidified, there is a sharp change in the vapor pressure temperature curve beyond the point B, as shown by the curve BC. As shown by the curve BC offer the solid solvent, as the vapor pressure curve of a solution is less than that of the solvent. The vapor pressure curve of the liquid solvent, as represented by the curve DE, that is DE, the curve DE is the solution 1. The vapor pressure curve of the solution 1 is seen intersect the solvent at E. The E point is the liquid is converted to solid, that is at a lower temperature. It is denoted by T1. Therefore, T1 is represented by the freezing point of the solution 1, and thus the depression in freezing point delta T or delta TF is given by T0 minus T1. Therefore, the solution 1 of the depression in freezing point equal to delta T1 equal to T0 minus T1, as the same way, solution 2 of the depression in freezing point is delta 2 T2 equal to T0 minus T2. These two are the solution 1 and solution 2 of the depression in freezing points delta T1 and delta 2. It is important to note that depression in freezing point of the solution 2 is greater than that of the solution 1. Thus, in general, more the concentration of the solution, greater will be the depression in freezing point. For dilute solutions, the curves, and that is the curves EF and HC are approximately parallel straight lines. That is, in this graph, EF and HC. These four and EF and HC are equal parallel straight lines. Therefore, triangle is BEF. And BHC, these two triangles are similar, and hence EF by HC equal to BE by FH. EF is T0 minus T1, HC is T0 minus T2, BE is P0 minus P1, and FH is P0 minus P2. Therefore, delta depression in freezing point is proportional to the P0 minus P, where P0 equal to vapor pressure of the solvent, P1 equal to vapor pressure of the solution 1, P2 equal to vapor pressure of the solution 2, where P0 minus P equal to lowering of vapor pressures. So hence, depression in freezing point is directly proportional to the lowering of the vapor pressure, that is delta TB, delta TF is proportional to the P0 minus P. Similarly, depression in freezing point and elevation in boiling point is these two Colgate properties are directly proportional to the relative lowering of vapor pressure. So, delta TF is proportional to P0 minus P. So, the students, you can calculate the molecular weight of the non-volatile solute particles in each Colgate property. Same as the in this property, we can calculate the non-volatile solute particles molecular weight. Determination of molecular weight from the depression in freezing point. According to Raoult's law, P0 minus P by P0 is proportional to Wm by small m into capital W. Here, where W equal to weight of the solute in grams, capital W equal to weight of the solvents in grams, M equal to molecular weight of the non-volatile solute particles, we can calculate this small m. So, above the equation, P0 minus P is proportional to the Wm by M into W into P0, where since the molecular weight of the solvent M and P0 is also these two are constants at a fixed temperature, the above equation becomes capital M and P0 are remove this equation. P0 minus P equal to W by M into small m into W. From equation 2 and 3, we get delta TF is proportional to W by M into W. Here proportionality is removed, then introduce the proportionality constant KF, where Kf is the constant called freezing point constant or kyroscopic constant or molar depression in constant. In this previous section, depression in freezing point or elevation in boiling point in delta Tb equal to Kb. So Kb is ebullioscopic constant. Here delta Tf equal to Kf. Kf is the kyroscopic constant. So delta T equal to Kf into W by m into W. So in case molality of the solution is 1, when 1 mole of the solute is dissolved in 1000 grams of the solvent, then delta T equal to Kf. So the definition of the kyroscopic constant is, thus the molar depression constant may be defined as the depression in freezing point produced dissolving 1 mole of any solute in 1 kg of the solvent. Again, repeat, the definition of the kyroscopic constant is defined as the depression in freezing point of the freezing point produced dissolving 1 mole of the any solute in 1 kg of the solvent. Thus, in general, delta T equal to Kf into molality of the solution. In case weight of the solvent given in grams, equation becomes delta T equal to Kf into W by m into 1 by W by 1000 grams. Therefore, molecular weight of the non-volatile solute particles equal to Kf into W into 1000 by delta T into W. So, who can calculate the non-volatile solute particles? We know the depression in freezing point, weight of the solute and weight of the solvent and depression in freezing point. So we calculate non-volatile solute particles.